Hey guys, Megamatt1254 here again. Welcome back to another episode of MGM Reviews. I'm joined here by my good friend Rowdy.
Hey yo, what's up? Hope y'all are doing good this night.
And, what we're doing today, guys, is we're going to be covering one of the weirdest films ever made. It is a... I don't even know what this is. It's like a horror, comedy, satire, mockumentary type of thing. It's like a blend of a bunch of genres. But and the film we're talking about, guys, obviously, if you read the title, is American Psycho with Christian Bale and Willem Dafoe. And, guys, give you our thoughts, what we like, what we didn't like, all that good stuff. So without further ado, guys, let's get straight into this review. So, American Psycho, what did we think of this movie? Well, I don't know about you, Rowdy, but I fucking thought this movie was a friggin' a masterpiece. I thought it was hilarious. What about you?
Oh, yeah, I'm honestly right on board with you. I mean, I thought it was just some, you know, shit post. I mean, when I first heard about it from you and the boys, but when we watch it together, man, I mean, it is kind of a shitpost and a meme fest, but it's also just genuinely a really fucking dope and enjoyable movie. It's one I would definitely go back on, so I can definitely agree with the masterpiece thing. It's a really fun movie, and I love it.
Yeah, agreed. I think what makes this movie work so much is that it's so fucking ridiculous. Like, for example, you'll have, like, a scene where, like, frickin' Patrick Bateman, right, the character, he'll, like, frickin' straight up murder somebody. Like, he kills Paul Allen. And then he'll straight up just be dragging his body through a freaking lobby in a hotel. Security guards just staring at it, not giving a crap. He's able to just put the body in the freaking trunk of a cab, and friggin' he's able to just get away with all this shit. And he'll straight up just talk about his psychotic thoughts out loud, and everybody will just act like he didn't even say it. It's like, it's so ridiculous, but I think that's a strength for the film. I think this movie isn't trying to be taken super seriously, and I think it works in its favor for that reason. I mean, heck, guys, if you go online, friggin', I guarantee you, you have seen memes of Patrick Bateman, and friggin', this film, like, for that reason, is, like, why it's so crazy. That's why people meme about it so much, just because this film is so friggin' out there, but also has a very deep and centered message, and that's what I love about it, is it does bring awareness to, like, mental health and shit like that. Like, people that, you know, are, you know, having, you know, crazy friggin' thoughts like that, that it's pretty crazy, you know? Like, it actually does, you know, bring awareness to stuff like that. And, you know, they managed to tell a really compelling message in the film while also doing all this fucking crazy shit.
Yeah, I'm, what I like is that it's so over the top and out there. Like, a lot of the stuff is really out there and crazy, and you kind of think, man, like, how's this guy getting away with everything? Like, what's going on here? You know, he's being investigated, that no one suspects him. Like, he's just always able to just do all this stuff, like, perfectly. Like, he's like always getting it perfect. Like, when he drops the chainsaw, manages to hit the woman when she's running away from him, man, that scene is frigged. But and then you have the twist at the end with how, I mean, it's very much just implied that legit the entire, like, events of the film were all in Patrick Bateman's head, and kind of adding on to what Matt said about mental health, it really just adds on to the whole, like, the schizophrenia thing. Like, we could really tell, like, it was all in his head, and that's why I like the twist at the end. You think, oh no, he's just a psychotic murderer, but no, he's just this mentally ill man who, like, has sick, twisted fantasies, which is hinted at in the book found by the girl, I forgot her name, at the end when she opened his notebook, and then you found all the rigged up drawings. So it's a really interesting twist at the end. I really did not see that coming. It's a really shocking twist. Like, it kind of just explains the whole movie. There's a lot of, it explains a lot, and it makes you really question, I say, it almost makes you question, like, is he still a monster? Like, what? How do you deal with a person like that? What do you think of a person like that? A person who just has twisted thoughts, like, how do you perceive that person? Just a person who has sick, twisted thoughts and sick, twisted fantasies that that Patrick Bateman had, but they don't act on it, like, is that a bad person? It makes you really question stuff like that, and that's one of the reasons I absolutely love this movie.
Yes, agreed. That's actually something I love that they did with the film, is they make you almost, they leave it up to your interpretation whether the events of this film happened or not. And at least in my personal opinion, it's like, I think it was in his head, just because realistically, if he did like commit these brutal, awful murders, there's no freaking way he'd be able to just be dragging this body through the hallway. Security guard just doesn't give a crap, especially with the blood coming out and shit. Like, realistically, he would have been arrested on the scene for that. Also, a scene that heavily implies that he is losing it mentally and that it is in his head is when he picks up the stray cat, right? And, like, he sees, like, the ATM and it says, friggin' feed me a stray cat, which, obviously, it's in his head. It kind of just shows you. It's, like, it's kind of implied that he is just imagining all these awful things happening. But in the same token, there are things that also kind of hint towards that it could be real. Like, for example, when a character dies in this film, for instance, like when he kills Paul Allen, or like when he kills the freaking prostitute that you see a few times throughout the film, they're never seen in the movie again. Like, the only hint of Paul Allen even still being alive is when the lawyer says he had dinner with him in London. But then again, the lawyer could have just been covering for Bateman so he didn't look like he just confessed a murder in public. So it's very open to discussion, but those are just our theories on it, guys. How do I actually feel about, you know, like, some of the, like, plots and characters in this film? Well, without a doubt, guys, Patrick Bateman, he is the star of this whole thing. He's easily what keeps this movie going. Like, you don't have this movie without his character, and Christian Bale does a fantastic job in this role. He is very good at, like, you know, feeling like a legitimate, like, psychopath. Like, you almost feel uneasy watching this guy sometimes. And it's a very well done performance, and it's probably one of Christian Bale's best, if not his best performance he's ever done. And now, in terms of some other characters, I really like Willem Dafoe's character. I like how he's very mysterious. Like, you can't quite tell if he's on to Patrick, or if he's just, you know, wanting to get more information out of him. But it's weird, though, because, like, it almost seems like he's on to him, but then he just never busts him. He never arrests him. So you're almost, like, left to interpret that character as well. It's cool stuff. And, yeah, some of the other characters in this film are great, too. Like, well, friggin' Paul Allen. He's a friggin' meme himself. Like, friggin'...
Hey, you, Paul!
Exactly. And fucking, let's be honest, if you haven't, like, watched this film, you already know the names Patrick Bateman, Paul Allen, without even having to watch this film. You probably already have heard those names. You've probably seen all the memes of him chopping him up and shit. Like, it's one of the most memed movie scenes in history, and it's actually one of my favorite death scenes in a film, just because friggin' it's so over the top and ridiculous. And the way Christian Bale, like, performs that, when, like, friggin' you got Paul and he's, like, drunk and he's like, is that a raincoat? And you got Christian Bale, he's all, like, happy and cheery. He's like, yeah, yes it is! Like,
is that a raincoat? Yes it is! Hey, Paul!
God, like, it's so frigged. Well, what's your thoughts on some of the characters? Yeah, hip to be square, exactly. What are your thoughts on some of the characters in the movie?
I'm definitely with you on a lot of them. I mean, Paul Allen, despite, you know, his character dying, you know, around 30 minutes in, he was definitely a very interesting, memeable character. And I like how much, you know, freaking in his head, you just, and just even verbally, Patrick Bateman fucking despises this dude. And then, yeah, his death is just, what the frig? I mean, it's brutal, but, you know, it's so memeable and frigged up. I mean, it's so well shot. I mean, Patrick Bateman's without obviously the main focus. I mean, you don't get a crap ton with the other characters. I mean, yeah, you have the detective, who's a really dope character. Just love the whole investigation stuff. As with Matt was saying, you really, it's really hard to kind of see, you know, where he's standing. And then there's the other characters, the two prostitutes he murders later in the film. Holy frig, that freaking the porn scene where they freaking shoot the pornography. Oh my. I mean, I've seen frigged scenes in shows and films, but that is among the most just what the fuck out there scenes I've ever seen. Like, and not even in a bad way. I'm just like, wow, I was freaking, my jaw just dropped. I was like, what the heck, man?
Like, what is this shit? Like, you know, like, frick.
Oh, yeah. Exactly. It was like, what the frig? I mean, it's the type of stuff you wouldn't really see that type of crap in a movie today because of just how crap is now. You really wouldn't see that type of stuff.
Well, yeah, I feel like if American Psycho was made today, I guarantee you more than 50% of this film would have been censored.
Oh, without a doubt. I mean, like, the actual deaths, no. I mean, if anything, movies and the horror movies have gotten more, you know, gore nowadays. But yeah, stuff like, you know, yeah, stuff like the horror, you know, in the horror industry, you know, doesn't really get censored when it comes to gore. But yeah, stuff like the nudity and stuff, it would have would be censored. I guess, unless, like, it depends where the movie really went, I'd say. It depends, you know, on the publisher who produced it. It would really obviously depend. Like, let's say this was, like, a Netflix original movie, no chance in freaking, you know, no chance that it's gonna have even a single bit of nudity in it. But if it's HBO, it'd probably be even worse, actually.
Oh, dear God. Yeah, they ain't that a fact. Fuck.
Yeah, for real. But, yeah, again, I like a lot of the characters, and without a doubt, Patrick Bateman just being the most over-the-top, crazy character. That's the thing. This movie is just, it's just simply over-the-top, and it's a fun just 90 minutes of pure just fuckery.
Craziness, and yeah.
Exactly. Like, I'm not sure if this is what you're supposed to get out of the movie, but this is just at least what I took out of it. But at the same time, it is still scary, because Patrick Bateman is still scary. Like, it's not just some, like, you know, mockumentary comedy stuff. Like, you can actually take Bateman seriously at times. I mean, not always, because, I mean, he is, you know, quote-unquote a joke to his, you know, employees, his freaking co-workers, and which is kind of said at the end, you know, like, Patrick Bateman, you know, killing people, ha ha ha, kind of just implies that he could literally, like, do all this stuff, kill people, you know, Paul Allen, murder everybody, and he will just get away with it.
Yep, and it's heavily implied that whether it's in his head or if he did it, the reason that no one suspects that he did it is because no one believes that he's enough of a man to even do it, because everyone thinks he's a dweeb.
Exactly. That's the, you know, that's the big message there. Like, regardless, here's the thing, regardless, if it's in his head or if he actually did it, does it really matter?
Exactly. That's the brilliant message of the film, I'd say.
Yeah, unless you count that stupid little sequel, which we will not talk about.
Yeah, which, thank God, that's not canon.
Yep, that is not canon, and, yeah. Well, that's what happens when you write a movie, and halfway through production, you decide it's a sequel.
I'm actually curious, guys. Leave a comment down below if you'd like us to cover that movie down the line, because, oh boy.
You know what's sad? That would mean me watching that movie. I mean, I've heard some stuff about it. I won't spoil it, just in case for some reason you people here want to watch it, but, Frig. I mean, I might. Like I said, it'd be a fun one to do. But just know, guys, if we do cover this one, it's probably gonna be a massive rant.
More than likely.
Exactly. Like, yeah.
This is what I'll say. Like, for my big final thoughts of the film, is I'll say my favorite scene of the film is easily the whole nighttime freaking shootout freaking scene. Oh, it's just so ridiculous.
The revolving door?
Yeah, that's the best kill in the movie, low-key. I like how it starts off with him just going for a nightly stroll. picks up a cat, tries to feed it to a fucking ATM machine, caps an old lady, freaking blows up two cops' cars like it's fucking Grand Theft Auto, freaking runs away like fucking into a building, shoots a random freaking dude at the desk in the head, freaking janitor comes out, he goes back through the freaking door, freaking shoots him and goes back in the door, freaking, and then runs to his freaking apartment, and then you think he's about to cap the next character, right? Like, the next guy? And then he just pulls out a pen, and then friggin' he runs into his apartment, which I just love. It adds to the whole friggin' charm of this film. I like how when he goes in his apartment, you can clearly just see that, like, the background windows are just, like, painted pictures. I don't know why. I actually love that. It just adds to, like, the ridiculousness of the whole movie. And, friggin', he, like, confesses everything to his lawyer on the phone and shit, and, yeah, that's definitely my favorite sequence of the film, just because you get all the best parts of the film. You get, like, the action, the insanity of frickin' Patrick Bateman, the comedy, the horror with him, like, confessing everything to the lawyer and shit, like, it's just an amazing, yeah, like, a total mental breakdown.
Yeah, like, his performance there is just wow. Like, I love how he can, like, Christian Bale, he can go 1 minute to playing, like, this monster psychopath, like, angry psychopath, like, over the top monster, but then he can actually just play, like, an emotional mess. Like, you know, like, I'm not saying you necessarily felt bad for him when he was breaking down the phone, but you really, like, he really sold, like, an emotional performance. Like, he actually sounded like he was broken.
I love the scene too, right, where he's talking on the phone to the lawyer, like he's leaving the voicemail, and I like how he just says it in this line, like, it's like kind of implied, but like you're not supposed to, like, it's almost like he himself finally catches on to that he's a psychopath. I love the line where he's just like, no, I guess I'm a pretty sick guy, and I'm like, gee, you don't say there, buddy.
It's like he doesn't even know, like, he doesn't even understand. It's like almost like childlike in a way, like when he's killing the people, right, like, you know, the bum on the street, Paul Allen, the women, it's almost like in a weird, sick, twisted way, it doesn't click that what he did was fucked up till, you know.
Well, yeah, it's almost like he doesn't even know what he's doing is bad, like he thinks it's okay to just do this.
Not even that it's okay, like, just the, he just almost just didn't, you know, it didn't click with them that what he was doing was absolutely vile, you know what I mean? And that's what I like. It's just, the movie just makes you think in all these different ways. Like, there's so much things that digest in this film. Despite it being a relatively overall simple film, it's almost a bit like, something like, let's say an episode of Breaking Bad or an episode of Better Call Saul. Like, there was a lot, you know, just bare base value. Then if you look deep into the movie, you know, visual storytelling, deep in dialogue, like, there's always these little things that just come out the more you look into it. And there's, like, there's a lot of that I've noticed in American Psycho, whether it comes from, again, dialogue or visuals. There's a lot of, like, stuff hidden under what you can see. There's a lot of stuff in between the lines, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, exactly. In terms of flaws for the movie, I really don't have any, to be honest at all. I mean, if I had to nitpick, I guess the color scheme of the movie's kind of dull, but, like, that's not even, like, a complaint at all. Like, at least for me, I don't have any complaints. What about you?
Me neither. I mean, also, one thing's for sure, I mean, the movie's from 2000, right? It released in 2000?
Yep.
I mean, it definitely shows that it's a 2000 movie with, like, you know, with Bateman using the old, you know, old-ass style phone, but at the same time, like, you know, why would, that's not something necessarily to complain about. I mean, it shows that it's from 2000, but at the same time, it does still hold up today. Like, it is a product of its time for sure, and it definitely shows that, but it does hold up in a, like, modern setting, like, 22 years later, and I think that works very well, so I can't really say that's even a flaw. It's always like, I guess, like, if I had to bring up something that's even remotely a flaw, it'd be that, but really, overall, I can't put that as a flaw. This movie is a straight-up 10 out of 10 masterpiece on my end.
I can agree. And actually, before I cap this review off, I'll actually say one thing that really helps in this movie's favor is getting with the times. Because think about it. The world, it gets more stressful, like, as time goes on. Like, the world gets, like, a lot more stressful. And it's almost like, obviously, without the psycho and killing and shit, it's almost like, without, like, all the psychotic shit, you can almost, like, relate to Patrick in a way with, like, you know, just the world feeling like you don't belong, like feeling left out and all that, like with all the craziness of the world. Like in that way, I like how like it almost connects with viewers that way.
Yeah, like obviously again, like doesn't mean everyone in the world is gonna in the world to be some crazy psycho, but yeah, there's definitely that message there about, you know, stress and just trying to make it in the world, like, and how that can affect you kind of more, you know, kind of almost connecting to the whole theme with the mental health and not necessarily schizophrenia, but how like the world, you know, the way it works and stress from it can impact your mental health, and it could be important to, you know, watch over that and make sure your mental health is in check.
Exactly. Well, I think that's all I have to say for the film. Do you have anything you want to add?
Simply this. I've got some tapes to return.
There we go. And with that being said, guys, that is going to be a wrap-up on the American Psycho review. MGM Reviews Season 3 is, like, back at full force, guys. We're doing movie reviews, game reviews, tons of more reviews coming your way. As you can tell with this review, guys, I'm trying to step up my production values a lot with my reviews. And the only way I would ever go back to, like, the Minecraft-style reviews is for, like... Actually, I was actually going to announce this on something else, but I can just say it quickly here. Is I am doing a new thing called MGM Quickies, which they're going to be very quick reviews for things that I can just quickly do on Minecraft. Make it, like, 5 to 7 minutes and just give my quick thoughts on something. MGM Reviews will be high production. MGM Quickies will be, like, the old Minecraft reviews, so... Yeah, let me know what you guys think about that in the comments. And that is about it for this video, guys. If you want us to cover more movies and games or whatnot, you know, suggest in the comments, like American Psycho 2, like a new Walking Dead spinoff or whatever.
I mean, hey, Dead City, I'd love to cover that. American Psycho 2? oof.
Get out of here with that.
Get out of here, but hey, regardless, you know, you got suggestions, leave them down. We'll consider anything. Again, if it's media, movie, show, game, anything's up for review, as long as, well, we'll have to check it out first, but anything's eligible to be reviewed. So honestly, anything you want to see reviewed, leave it down in the comments. We'd be glad to hear what you want to see.
Yes, and that is going to be it for this video, guys. I'm done rambling here. I'm going to put my verdict up on the screen real quick, guys. And
Huey Lewis in the news. Great stuff. I just bought it on my way here. You heard it?